In this tutorial, we will learn to configure round robin with DNS failover. Along with distributing the load between multiple servers, this technique also vastly increases redundancy. In this example, we are going to split the traffic 50-50 between two individual web servers. If one server goes down, it will fail over to the other server, handling 100% of the traffic. Please note, in this more advanced tutorial, you should already be familiar with DNS failover, working with A records, configuring round robin in A records, and working with CNAME records. If you are unclear on any of these processes, please click one of the frames above to view a video tutorial on that subject. To start, click on Manage DNS under the DNS tab in the main menu. If you have recently modified the domain you want to work with, you can choose it from the Recently Updated Domains list. If your domain is not listed, enter your domain name in the Manage DNS search box. For this example, we will be working with the domain example.com. Once your domain has been loaded, click the Records tab if it is not already the active tab. Click the plus sign associated with the A records grid. Since we will be creating round-robin A records for the root record, leave the name field blank. In the IP field, enter the IP address of the first server you'd like to distribute traffic to. For our example, we will be using non-public IPs. Our first IP will be 192.168.1.2. For a faster failover, set your TTL to 300 seconds. Please note, be certain to not set your TTL too low. Too low a value may be ignored by some ISPs, which will default to a much higher value. DNS Made Easy recommends a TTL no lower than 180 seconds. Once you've entered the information for your first record, click the Submit button and enter the IP address of the second web server you want to split the traffic with. We're entering 192.168.1.3 and clicking Submit to add the second root record. Once you've confirmed your changes, close the Add A Records window. Now that our root A records are configured to use round robin, it's time to configure DNS failover. Our failover configuration will have the 192.168.1.2 server fail over to the 192.168.1.3 and vice versa. To do this, click the word off in the SM/FO column in your A records grid next to 192.168.1.2 or whichever IP address you've configured to open the monitoring and failover window for that record. Click the checkboxes associated with monitoring notifications and DNS failover to activate them. For this example, we are only configuring HTTP check on port 80. Please note, when configuring DNS failover with round robin, you always want to make sure your port to monitor, protocol, and other special configuration options used in your monitoring are the same for all of your A records. Enter the IP you wish to fail over to, in this case, 192.168.1.3. Click OK once your configuration is completed. A success window will appear to confirm you've entered your information correctly. If you do not receive this prompt, review your settings and try again. Now that we've got the server at 192.168.1.2 failing over to 192.168.1.3, we need to go back and repeat the process to configure 192.168.1.3 to fail over to 192.168.1.2. Click the word off in the SM/FO column in your A records grid next to 192.168.1.3 or whichever IP address you've configured to open the monitoring and failover window for that record. Click the checkboxes associated with monitoring notifications and DNS failover to activate them. Configure everything on this screen to match the record we configured earlier with the exception of the IP address. This time around, we'll enter the first IP address of 192.168.1.2. Once completed, both servers will be able to fail over to one another in the event of a system failure, redistributing 100% of the traffic to the still functional server. To give your users the flexibility of accessing your site by typing either www or a naked domain, we are going to create a CNAME record. Click the plus sign associated with the CNAME record type in your records grid. Name the record WWW. Since the CNAME record will act as an alias to the root A records, give it the same 300-second TTL you gave those previously. Congratulations! You have just configured DNS failover with Round Robin. This same configuration can be used with up to 13 A records in a single Round Robin configuration. To add more A records, simply follow the first few steps of this tutorial. For our full support knowledge base, please visit http://support.dnsmadeeasy.com. For more tutorials and lessons on using DNS Made Easy, please visit http://help.dnsmadeeasy.com.